by me will be saved, and will come in and go out and find pasture. Very famous words from our Lord and Savior, who describes himself as both the gate and the shepherd. This has been traditionally understood in very exclusive terms. By nature, it sounds very exclusive, actually, as you read it. That you either enter into a relationship with God via Jesus Christ, or you do not have a relationship with God at all. In fact, as Christians, we do hold that Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Oh, we gotta have more conviction than that. We do hold that Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen?
Amen.
All right. And that Jesus Christ is the one through whom salvation comes. Amen?
Amen.
That is sound Christian theology. However, we have tended to get a little bit on the judgmental side with that. We're in, you're not. Amen?
No.
No. Gotcha. But we do. We tend to think we're in, you're not, as if we are the judges of that. And yet, by virtue of that judgmental attitude, we are fence hopping rather than truly entering in through the gate. So let us affirm that Jesus Christ is the way, the gate to salvation. Can I get an amen to that?
Amen.
Okay, Jesus, yeah, I'm not tricking you this time. Jesus is the way and the gate to salvation. But let us also pause to evaluate what that actually means. If Jesus is the gate, and that is the way to a right relationship with God, then we had better pay attention to what it means to enter in through that gate. Amen?
Amen.
Jesus states that his sheep recognize his voice, the voice of the shepherd, and they listen to that voice, as opposed to the voice of thieves and robbers who came before him. The question for us this morning is this: what does this mean for us? What are the voices that came before Christ in our lives that act as thieves and robbers seeking to destroy our relationship with God? Do any of you know what those voices are in your context? Oh, you thought that was rhetorical. How about the voice of division? It exists in every congregation, does it not? Ours included. We hold on to things from the past and refuse to let them go. We allow them to manifest in many different ways. How about the voices of power, of money, of fear, of control, of independence, of our insecurities? Do any of you have any of those that you'd like to share?
Whoa.
No, I say that partly joking. I don't want you to air your dirty laundry if you don't want to air your dirty laundry. But maybe some of you are going through something that would be a help to share. That would be a burden off your shoulders to get it out there so you can be supported by your faith community. Because then, when we acknowledge they exist, we can deal with them. We can't deal with them if we bury them under lies and hiding them from other people so that no one thinks we're imperfect. By the way, we're all imperfect, so we can just take a deep sigh of relief there, right? Not one of us is perfect in this room today, with the exception of the Holy Spirit, who is here. If Jesus is the gate, we will seek the way of unity instead of discord. We will seek to share resources, power, and position instead of trying to lord those things over everybody else. We will seek to live as the earliest church did in our first scripture reading in Acts. How did they live, by the way?
Communally.
Communally. They sold everything they had, their property, their possessions, their money, all of that. And they gathered it and collected it and gave it away for the whole of the community, so that the whole community could share in what they had. If Jesus is the gate, we will seek to love as Jesus loved. To be peacemakers who live justly, who love mercy, and who walk humbly with their God. We will seek to be a people of faith, not fear. This is a big one. And as we go through transition and go from one pastoral leadership to the next, we need to very carefully evaluate, are we responding out of faith? Or are we responding out of fear? Which is the voice of Jesus? Faith. Faith. A people, we will be a people, if we see Jesus as the gate, we'll be a people who do what's right over what is convenient and or profitable. Faith over fear. Right. Over easy. Jesus says, indeed, I am the gate. Those who come in through me will be saved. This is the core of our faith. Amen?
Amen.
And it takes faith to even find that gate. Amen?
Amen.
We're not perfect, but our faith in the Good Shepherd will draw us closer and closer to the gate. We will hear the Good Shepherd's voice over those other voices and grow stronger in avoiding them. So the challenge is for you to begin to intentionally distinguish the voices that you hear. Are they Jesus's? Are they not? It's a very clear distinction. And if we know Jesus, if we read the Bible, or if we have any sort of spiritual life, their lives, we will be able to distinguish that. The challenge is for us to begin to intentionally distinguish the voices Jesus from what's not Jesus's, and discipline ourselves to follow Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
I know you are praying that for me as I transition to a new church, and I am praying that for you as well. We've done awesome things here at Harmony Hill, and I know awesome things will continue to happen here. But it is important for all of us, no matter where we go, that the voice we listen to is the voice of Jesus. It is important that the gate we enter through is the gate into the sheepfold, not the gate into the world. Amen?
Amen.
Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we thank you for this challenge of being your sheep and responding only to your voice. Lord, as we move forward in this time of transition, let us hear your voice. Let us hear your voice and respond to your call so that we may have the direction of the gate and enter into the sheepfold. We pray these things in